Hi, my name is Steve Dundas. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Applied Economics at Oregon State University. How do economists estimate the current value of costs and benefits of a policy change that is likely to have impacts both now and in the future? The answer is by using a discount rate. Discounting is the process of converting the value of a benefit received in the future to an equivalent value received today. For example, a $100 payment received in 2 years is likely to be valued less than $100 that you can put in your pocket right now. Discounting is the process that adjusts the relative value of these two payments into a common metric to inform a decision today. The difference between present and future values makes it difficult to compare costs and benefits over time. There are three primary reasons why this difference in value exists. Number one, humans are generally an impatient species. People value current period benefits more than they value the same benefits received in the future. We also like to push costs into the future rather than paying for something now. This latter point can be illustrated by considering the abundant use of credit cards in our economy. Number two, people expect to grow wealthier over time. If we expect to have more money in the future, then having an extra dollar today is more valuable than having that same dollar in the future. Number three, money received today can be saved or invested. Therefore, the value of a dollar received today is greater than the value of a dollar received in the future, because it can be invested now and begin earning a return immediately. The concept of discounting is applied to policy analysis through the choice of a discount rate. Current application of a discount rate in US policy circles ranges between 2 and 7%. Now, what exactly does that number mean? First, let's consider setting the discount rate equal to zero. This implies that the current and future benefits are valued equally today, and that society has no preference between receiving a benefit today or at some point in the future. A second option is setting the discount rate to a small or low value, like 2%. This implies that the present benefits are valued more and given more weight in a policy analysis than future benefits, but only slightly. A third option is setting the discount rate to a large or higher value, like 7%. This implies that society values present benefits much more so than benefits that would occur in a future time period. There are two general approaches to deciding what discount rate to apply to a policy analysis. The first is the prescriptive or normative approach. Under this line of reasoning, we would ask ourselves the question, how should society make trade-offs between benefits to current and future generations? This requires making ethical judgments about how much we should value people's well-being at different points in time. By contrast, the descriptive or positive approach asks the question, how do individuals and markets trade off current and future consumption? This approach bases choosing a discount rate on observable, realized outcomes in societies, such as interest rates. To review, discounting is a critical decision made by economists in policy analysis that brings current and future benefits and costs into an apples-to-apples value comparison to aid in policy design and implementation. The importance of this concept is evident when the benefits and costs of a policy change may span generations, as is the case with climate change.